Episode 1988, Champion Your Spouse.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy day. I hope you're having a very blessed weekend. Today is Relationship Builders. You need to focus on your marriage. We focus on everything else in life, but very rarely do we focus on the one who we sleep with. It's time to rise and champion your spouse. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, championing your spouse is a great way to encourage and support your spouse. Awaken the hope that touches the heart. Be present in the everyday. Don't just assume your spouse feels or hears your support. You want to act it out loud. Now, if you disagree or wanted something else your way, guess what? You would most certainly be loud about it. You might even find yourself kicking and screaming to get what you want. So why not kick and scream to encourage and support your spouse? You know, we get it all backwards. We yell at each other about everything. We get mad at each other because stuff isn't picked up off the floor. Because, oh wait, they were supposed to stop by the grocery store and pick up a few extra things and it didn't happen. We are so quick to anger, but we are so slow to cheer. Why is that? Why do we feel like we have to attack before we cheer? What would happen in your relationship if you would cheer more than you yelled? What would happen if you encouraged more than you were mad? It might really flip a lot that happens in your marriage. But unfortunately, we as human beings are carved out to be these sinful creatures that attack, that see only the negative. We have to work for the positive. And it takes intentionality to get there. It doesn't just happen. Now, there are some people that are optimistic, and it is fantabulous. But a lot of us are not made that way. So why would you want to kick and scream at your spouse anyway? I mean, does that really get you closer to what you want? I don't think so. What if you were to love him? What if you were to show him every single day how much he means to you? Why not kick and scream to encourage and support your spouse? Don't you think he deserves to feel loved and supported, uplifted, and noticed? You got to be intentional about celebrating your spouse. You got to celebrate your wife. You got to say, you know what, hon? You have never cooked a better meal. Now, don't just say it to say it. I want it to come from the heart. So if it's not one of the better meals she's ever cooked, don't say it because then you will be in the doghouse and we don't want you there. But the thing is most of the time we're like, oh, couldn't you have done this? Like, we pull the negative again. Why? Stop gravitating towards the negative. Don't let the negative be your gravity in your everyday. Be intentional about celebrating your spouse because when you champion, you celebrate life together. And that's a beautiful thing. So instead of fighting loudly, champion your spouse. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Champion your spouse. Now, as I wrote this a little bit and I tried to pronounce champion, that ing really does get you in the pronunciation. But as I thought about it, a lot of us are just kind of pretending to show up. We put that cute smile on in the morning and send them off to work. We greet them when our spouse comes home with open arms. And then it's like, yeah, now I'm done with you. I just want to go do my own thing. Seriously? You've got to be willing to put in the work. You've got to be willing to go beyond a three-letter sentence. Yeah, I love you. Unfortunately, it falls a lot on deaf ears because we don't support that sentence that we're using. And I know this comes by a surprise, but if we're just saying, I love you, and we're not meaning it, how is that serving you in your marriage? So start backing up and being a cheerleader for your spouse. Champion your spouse. What does that look like? Number one, speak words that reflect explosive growth. We are quick to cut, but slow to love. Quick to get mad, slow to be happy. Why is it that we're opposite? It doesn't make sense. You want to be quick to encourage, quick to lift up. You want to build up your spouse, not tear them down. So speak words that reflect explosive growth. This is always pushing your spouse what? Forward. And you know what? When life happens and things get a little bit testy, a little bit intense, this is a great time to have words and to really think about it. Like if you have to Google some words and say, you know what? This would mean a lot if I said it like this. Write it on a post-it and put it somewhere where you can remember that statement and include it in your everyday conversation with your spouse. Now, understand, if you don't mean it, then you better not say it. I mean, that's just like the hidden golden rule in marriage. If you don't mean it, you better not say it, because that can do more damage than saying nothing at all. But that is for another episode. So speak words that reflect explosive growth. You want to push your spouse forward. It's hard to do things on our own. It's hard when we make mistakes. It's hard when we don't see success always as an individual. But to have someone that loves you to come behind you and say, hey, babe, you got this. I know you didn't get that job promotion that you wanted, but guess what? There's another one coming up. I know it's 6 months away, but don't give up on your dream. Speak words that reflect explosive growth. Number two, listen intentionally to his desires and hopes. You know, us women, we can talk a lot. I mean, imagine me. Yes, I love to talk. Listen to me now. But the crazy thing is we are not listening to our spouses. They are going unheard. Did you know your spouse wants to be heard? Think about it. You want to be heard. So why are you not returning that to your spouse today, every day? Listen intentionally. Listen intently. This is all about your presence. You know, just because you throw out words, if you don't mean it, you shouldn't be saying them. Same thing. You can be in the same room, but if you are not actively listening to the conversation, don't pretend that you are. Because again, that does more damage. Speak words, listen intentionally. And finally, number three, cheer often. You know, I don't know what's going to happen with the football season. And you know, I am a huge fan of football, college ball, the NFL. I love it. Sports, yes. We all like what? To cheer. We always want to root for that underdog. We want to lift people up. We do that for teams that we can't actually engage in, but we don't do it for our spouse. Now, how backwards is that? That doesn't make any sense to me. You should want to be the biggest and the loudest cheerleader for your spouse. And you should cheer often, not just when, oh, wait, maybe I should say this now. It needs to be top of mind. You need to be looking for opportunities to cheer on your spouse every day. Now, I can hear it already. You're going, but I don't get that. It's not fair. Why can't I have that? I need that too. You're right. We all need that. But you right now and listening to this, you are being called to take the first step forward. And when you do that, you model it. And believe it or not, it will come back to you. I promise. But you have to be patient. And depending upon where you are in your relationship, you can actually sit down and say, you know what, hun? You are so good at yelling at me. I love you, but I don't need you to tell me over and over again my mistakes. I see them. Can you remind me that I need to live out our dreams? Can you remind me of the goals that I have? Can you remind me of the greatness that I'm trying to create in my everyday? Can you remind me that I'm a child of God? You know, it's those little things. Now, I know some relationships are not on solid footing, and so having that conversation might be more disruptive than helpful. So you have to look at your relationship and say, is this the right time? It may not be the right time to say, hey, this is what I need too. But it's always the right time to be the loudest cheerleader for your spouse. Always. Don't make assumptions in your marriage. Don't assume that your spouse knows that you are their biggest cheerleader. Because I got to tell you, he doesn't know. She doesn't always feel that way. And so you want to create the environment that says, you got this, babe. I am here for you. No matter what, you got this. So look at your marriage today. Look at your relationship. Go back just 24 hours ago. Replay it in your head. Were you one who was uplifting and encouraging, noticing the positive? Or were you using words that cut to the heart? That was more about tearing down. That really didn't do much of anything except, hey, yeah, I say this all the time. I hope you get it. I do love you. And I know most of us mean that in sincerity. But we can't say things out of habit. And we do. One thing I think I've shared with you before is a statement that I ask my husband, not every single day, sometimes every day. It just depends on our conversations. This week I haven't. Why? Because I've been gone. I've been with my daughter and my son-in-law. We got, by the way, just total side note, we finally got the grandbaby's room completely painted. Oh, yes, it looks adorable. One of these days I'll have to post pictures. But, you know, yes, just another thing on my list. But one thing I do say to my husband often, what can I do for you today? How can I serve you? Now, I don't ask that question or make that statement unless if I mean it. Unless if I know that I have made and carved out some time. Because there's nothing worse than my husband saying, oh, sweetheart, I need you to do this. Can you go do that? And then I say, well, no, that doesn't fit my schedule. So if I know my schedule is so jam-packed that adding in anything maybe extra might not happen, then I don't necessarily make that statement. I change the statement and say something along the lines of, my schedule is really packed, but if you need me to do something, I'm happy to try to make it work. Is there anything I can do for you today? You see, therefore, I've prefaced it, right, in saying what can really fit within my schedule. And sometimes it's not that big of a deal. But other times it's like, oh my gosh, between the kids' schedule, me coming and going, my work, and then just life in itself, isn't going to happen. I mean, it may just be a peekaboo of a window. And so I make sure that that expectation is set that I may not be able to get to do something huge as in a project, but maybe I can do something little. Champion your spouse. Are you doing that in your everyday? Or are you leaning on the side of just, oh, well, she's here, he's here. Yeah, my spouse is always here. So I'm just going to take him for granted again. Now, I know you're not thinking that, but your actions show that. Don't be that kind of spouse. Be the loudest cheerleader for your spouse. Go out, find an opportunity today to serve your sweetheart. Be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.